Good morning, Bella.
Good morning.
How are you?
Good.
Nice to meet you.
So I heard you're in the Air Force. Is there anything that if like anybody wanted to be in the Air Force that they should know about it?
Yeah, I am in the Air Force. I'm a helicopter pilot right now stationed at Andrews Air Force Base. Been here for about a year and in the Air Force for about six. I would say that if you're thinking about joining the Air Force or the military at all, it's a big decision. It's important to put in the years that you're thinking about it, put in the time, because it does change your life, and no matter what, you will have a commitment.
So you're active duty?
Yes.
So you still pilot helicopters?
Yes.
What's one of your favorite ones you've piloted?
Definitely the Huey. It's an old helicopter. It's been around since Vietnam, and you probably see them flying around all the time, making lots of noise, but it's so much fun. Nothing about it is an automated aircraft. Everything is responding to the inputs I put in.
What was it like the first time for you to fly a helicopter?
Very difficult. It was like trying to stand up in a hammock and control it and make it be still. Flying helicopters is very difficult the first time you do it, but once you get the hang of it, it's just like riding a bike.
What's a role that the Huey plays in the Air Force?
Here in the National Capital Region, we do continuity of government operations. In case anything bad happens, we would be charged with getting members of the government away to a safe area. Where I was previously was in Global Strike Command, and we did a lot of nuclear security. So primarily the Huey is for security purposes, and then it can also use it for personnel recovery for search and rescue operations.
What's flying over the DC Capitol like?
It's amazing. It's so much fun. There's a lot to look at. It's almost like having a scenic helicopter tour every time you fly. Very fortunate to be stationed here and able to fly in the National Capital Region, and especially like coming up with the cherry blossoms blooming, it's going to just be beautiful.
What type of obstacles did you have to overcome?
There are a lot of challenges that I've faced just in my short career in the Air Force. Everything from just getting into college to getting a pilot slot, getting through pilot training, all of that. None of that came easily to me. I really had to work on it. And if anything, that taught me that anyone can do this. If I could do it, anyone can. And then being a woman is different in the military, but the generation before me made it easier for me. I'm going to make it easier for you, and hopefully you make it easier for my daughter so that one day no woman will feel out of place or mistreated or alone in any career field she wants to be in.
What is something you're most likely to do after the Air Force?
For me, I just had my first kid. I had a daughter, and it's really changed the perspective I have for my life. So after I get out of the Air Force, I really want to go into serving kids, women, any underprivileged community. I have a big passion for that, and especially being here in DC, there's so many opportunities to get involved and volunteer and get involved in your community. So I would even look into going into politics after I get out of the Air Force.
Thank you so much for coming.
All right, Bella, how'd it go?
I was very nervous at first, and then I leaned more into the interview and I got better.
Nice.
How important is it for you to be able to give an interview to someone like Bella?
It's incredibly important. I see very much of myself in Bella and in every younger generation. This is an amazing opportunity for you. There's nothing like this when I was a kid. So I'm very, very proud to be a part of this with you.
Bella, how much fun was this today?
It was awesome. I'd be glad to do this again. We'll be right back.